Hi everyone, welcome to Snooze.
Why are you screaming?
I know.
I'm right next to you. And there's a microphone here. Why are you screaming?
It's kind of weird when you're talking to no one until they see it.
You're talking to me.
Oh. Hi everyone.
There you go.
If there were multiple Yuvals, I don't know what I would do.
You would have a heart attack.
Anyways, hello and welcome to Snooze News. I'm going to tone it down and not sound like a news anchor.
Thank you.
We just want to welcome it. I don't even remember what episode this is, but it doesn't matter. We did want to let you guys know that we created Snooze News to offer you an opportunity to find out whatever it is that you want to know about mattresses, sleep. But in all seriousness, if you have any questions, we're really trying to open this up for you. We want to make this a dialogue for what you want to know about mattresses and sleep, and why not approach the experts themselves, and we promise we'll make it funny. Sorry, my phone's on. anyways, so we're going to dive right into this topic. Oh, and so at the end of this segment, we are going to make a fun announcement for something that we at Texas Mattress Makers are going to be a part of. So
I love you, but you're long-winded today. What is wrong with you?
I know, right?
Right. What are we talking about today?
Today we're talking about box springs.
Thank you.
And it's a question that many of you had. Do I need a box spring? There's kind of a couple answers that we're going to go over with that. So I'm going to open the floor to the non-long-winded person.
That would be me. Thank God. We finally got here. 40 years in the desert.
Now, like he doesn't talk. Got me.
Box springs. So in the old days, it was very simple, right? You bought a mattress, you bought a box spring, you bought a bed frame. The box spring serves only two purposes, period. One, elevation, because you want to be high enough that when you put your tush in the bed, you're comfortable in it. Mm-hmm. And the second is support, all right? But in today's world, you have so many different options of bedrooms. So let's go over that for a moment. If you're buying a platform bed, now, platform means that you have a solid piece of wood that is going to support your mattress. You don't need a box spring.
Are those like the slates that you have?
No.
Okay.
By the way, slate. I'm the foreigner. She can't talk English. Slats.
Oh, slats.
Very good. Slate. Slate is what you put on the floor when you fell and hit your head when you were two.
That's the scar that you know, waking him up.
Internal. Anyway. Yes, you have beds that are called platform and they have slats.
Okay.
The problem with the slat is that it's not solid. Okay. And when you think of a mattress that has individual spring coils, okay, or even solid foam, and you lay on the bed and you don't have a solid platform under you, you're going to create a wave that is going to radiate downward.
So it actually hurts the lifespan of the mattress that you invested in.
Number one, which is absolutely true. And number two, it will never support you properly because some beds have really wide gaps. With the slat. Platform, solid, no need for a box.
Okay.
But let's say you bought a platform bed with slats. You don't need a regular box spring. What you need is what we call a bunkie board. It's about 2.5 inches high max. You put it under the bed, you put your mattress on it.
Okay, so that we actually have some content about, and you can view that in the text part of this. But so let's go into like your regular bed frame. So I bought a bed frame from Texas Mattress Makers. That looks like the metal bed frame. Want to explain that further because I've said slates or earlier.
Well, no. I have no problem telling you when you act weird.
No, so that actually you will need. That's the one that has that single metal.
Just a regular metal bed frame.
And you do need a box spring for that.
Yes, you do. Because it's just an exterior or perimeter frame. There you put a box. Now, as you said before, we have different heights of boxes because some people, for example, you have some folks that are a little shorter than others. For you and I are in different height, okay? You will not be as comfortable on a high bed getting into a high bed as I would, and I wouldn't be as comfortable getting into a lower bed as you would.
Yeah.
So we accommodate the heights, right?
Yes. So there's not a universal box spring, but there's options.
Right. Now, a lot of folks think that if they have a metal bed frame and they already have a mattress and a box spring, that they can buy just the mattress. Well, that's actually wrong. And the reason is because your box spring creates waves.
Okay.
So if you took your mattress away and kind of squatted down and looked at your box spring, you'd see very soft waves.
Like a body impression almost.
No, waves.
Like waves, okay.
Yes. You cannot put a new mattress because it immediately will take on those shapes.
Got it, okay.
Right? Now, if you have a piece of plywood at home,
yes.
And that's what makes you, I mean, you already have it, and you can put that piece of plywood on the old box and create a solid surface from tip, from end to end, head to toe, no problem. Come and get a mattress.
Okay, so does that mean that every time you buy a mattress, you need to replace your box spring?
I'm going to assume that the average replacement of a mattress is at least 3 years, minimally speaking.
Okay.
I'm sorry to say yes.
Okay, but that, okay, so it's important though, I'm gonna segue, are we mm-hmm. done with that? Does that mean that you have to spend a lot of money?
No.
Okay.
So in most places, when you buy a mattress set, mm-hmm. they will break down the price, like a 60, let's use an example, $1,000 is a set, okay?
Yes.
They'll tell you the mattress is or $600 or $700, and the box spring is or $400 or $300. It's expensive. Here we don't play these games.
That's why I have this face, because I'm not used to that.
Right.
Okay. Okay.
So most box springs, what you call box springs, or foundations, or solid platforms, however the terminology is, right? For us, it costs us the same whether we make it 2 inches, 4 inches, or 8 inches. And we're the least expensive in this town,
and
I guarantee you.
And the quality of our box springs that are made here.
Right.
They're great, I mean.
No, we use solid wood.
Okay.
And we ensure that every box spring will outlive any mattress you will ever buy.
Okay.
Okay? So it's made solid, and we make everything, as you should know by now, everything I do because
perfect.
I do.
He's perfect.
You know? I mean, I don't buy other people's stuff to tell you what they told me. I tell you what I know.
Well, okay, so here's something that I know I'm wondering, and maybe people who know about the bed-in-a-box industry. I'm always reading from the Caspers, the Purples, the Tufted Needles, those companies that you don't need a box spring with their products. So,
wrong!
Well, that's
it's all about timing. It's all about timing.
No, but that's important because
no.
I also am confused how a dense
right.
piece of memory foam, which is what their products are made of, how if you don't have that and you do have your traditional bed frame,
right.
how that's not going to cause...
It's not. Most people will assume that a lot of people already have a bed. So they're going to buy the new bed in a box, and they're going to take it home, they're going to put it in an old box. If they're buying a brand new bed, they probably went and bought, okay, a bed frame.
Okay.
If it's the one, like you're saying, just a regular steel bed frame,
mm-hmm.
They're going to be very unhappy. So the question is,
what type
should
of
you
frame?
Buy a box? It depends what kind of bed you're actually putting your mattress on. If it's a solid platform and a brand new bed, no. If it's slatted,
yes.
Slatted. Like that?
I
love that smile. Slatted. Okay.
Learn something new.
Right. If you would have missed the one tooth, you'd be the cutest thing on earth. Anyway, if you have a bed with slats, you have to buy something to put on top of it.
Okay.
Okay. The secret is whatever the size of the bed is, twin, full, queen, or king, you have to fill the whole area solidly.
Got it. So it needs to be a solid surface that you're putting your mattress on.
Correct. And if you can't do that because it's inconvenient or you don't have the tools or the wherewithal to do it, just get online and buy one from us. I guarantee you it's the least expensive one you'll ever get.
And that's true too. So let's say you already have a bed at home, but you don't have a box spring. You can buy here a box spring the same amount of money that it would have cost
mm-hmm.
in the set, you can buy by itself.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
And you can do that online. I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't say it like that. We hope that that was useful. If you have any questions about this segment, you can email us. You can comment on any of our social media. Let us know what you think, if you want to know anything else, or if you're confused, if you need to see pictures. Like I said before, we do have content related to this subject, and it's in the description. So we also mentioned that we have this exciting announcement.
Mm.
Texas Mattress Makers is the proud new partner. I'm clapping for some reason. Of the Dynamo and Dash, the Houston Dynamo and Dash.
No drugs. She does this naturally. There are no drugs involved.
One cup of coffee. No, but seriously, we're very excited to announce our partnership with the Dynamo and Dash. They actually came here last week and did a walkthrough with our factory. It was really exciting. And in 2020, we're going to actually start kind of making an appearance this year. And 2020, we're going to make a big thing out of it. Anyway, so again, if you have any questions about the mattress industry or the sleep industry, let us know and we'll make sure to make an episode of it. Yeah.
You don't want to know Yuval's morning routine. Trust me. Yuval doesn't want to know Yuval's morning routine.
I know his morning routine. It consists of, there's a cup of coffee that he has.
That's right. With lines on it. Top line is, don't look at me. Don't even think of looking at me. Okay?
I feel like I could be a news anchor.
What are we talking? Okay. I almost said slate.
See?
I'm becoming dumber sitting next to you. Oh my God.
I just got to keep you on your toes.
That's it. Not a body impression. I said waves.
I'm just trying to understand too.
I want them to understand, not you.
They may have the same questions.
You're here every day. How can you not understand what I'm saying?
Okay, so there's waves.
Waves, that's right. Like the ocean. Sharks.
That's unnecessary.
Okay.
It's my birthday this week.
I know. Give me a kiss.
Oh, I have lipstick.
Give me a kiss. You're not getting a present.
Shh. Yes, I am.
No, you're not. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Give me a kiss. You're still not getting a present.
He's still confusing himself. So we just
I'm going to wear a cheetah skirt with a thong.
This is very confusing.
Anyone that wants to go to that game, just buy a ticket. I guarantee you it's going to be the ugliest sight you've ever seen in your life, but it's going to be funny
as hell. I don't know if I'll be there because I'll be having an ulcer, wondering about...
You'll be there. Cheetah skirt and a thong, for God's sakes.
Anyways, and
sumo
then...
Sumo wrestlers wear it.
I'm uncomfortable.